Everyone, welcome to the show. Casey DeSantis joining you along with Curtis.
Hey, folks. Happy Wednesday. I'm Curtis Dvorak, and today is a major day here
special
in our city.
Day.
It's a really important day. I actually just had a chance to go across the street, the Jag Stadium. And ironically, I'm drinking out of my Champions for Hope water bottle I got from last year's golf tournament. Champions for Hope, JT Townsend Day is actually today, and Alvin Brown actually started this when he was mayor. And that's the crew with Judy Zatello and JT Townsend's mom and his sisters. And we just took a picture. I'm the one in the back holding the balloons, and you can kind of see me there. Such a great foundation. They do such great work. You did the hour-long Champions.
Oh, yeah, I know his family very well, Judy Zatello, all the supporters. I mean, there's a lot of people that you couldn't even sit here and name who have done so much to try to not only support JT, his mission, the foundation, raise money for a good cause. And so JT just did so much with his life. And he was such a positive and an optimistic person, given everything that had happened to him.
Yeah,
he inspired so many people, and his legacy lives on. And this is just one indication of that. So it's a great time to just remember JT, remember what he's done for the community, all the people who are supporting his mission, and say, hey, thanks. And I know people who met him, such as myself. I know you. All better for knowing him.
Yeah,
he's a great guy.
Done great work, and that foundation is still doing great work, raising money and helping out other families who are hit by, you know, paralysis and having somebody in their family and all the stuff you need, the equipment you need that you don't even know.
Yeah, the JT Townsend Foundation. So families who find themselves with children who have disabilities and they need certain kinds of
chairs and ramps,
equipment to make their life a little bit easier. Life-changing, because JT found that and his family found how this equipment could change their lives forever. They raise the funds, if it's not covered by insurance, to be able to afford that for this family. So if you want to make a donation, you can always, it's very easy just to Google JT Townsend Foundation and you'll get all the information you need. But it's good people, good
very
work.
Good people. And the tournament, Champions Rope tournament, is coming up in June, and we'll have more on that as we get along. But today is a big day, and celebrate JT Townsend wherever you are.
It's a big day today. It was a big day yesterday for the biggest rocket as it blasted off from Cape Canaveral on the first test flight. I'm sure you've heard about SpaceX.
Oh, my gosh. Powered by 5 million pounds of thrust, the spacecraft is part of an operation that is going to revolutionize the next generation of space travel. Watch this if you didn't see it.
Typical at T-7, 9, 8.
Under a perfect Florida blue sky, yet another of billionaire Elon Musk's dreams roared to life.
Ignition, liftoff.
The SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket with 27 engines thundering off the same launch pad that for decades sent Apollo and shuttle missions into space. This time, an unmanned mission to prove three rockets tied together could work in perfect synchrony, break the Earth's gravitational pull, and head for a journey into deep space. SpaceX Mission Control near Los Angeles, euphoric. And in a stroke of engineering genius, this. Two of the three rockets returned safely to Earth for reuse, setting off sonic booms as they broke through the atmosphere and hit their targets side by side.
It really feels like we've got a shot at going back to the moon, going to Mars, and reviving the spirit of exploration that was Apollo. And that was one of the things that got me so excited as a kid.
In Florida, the gathered crowds could feel the thunder in the sky.
It must be experienced live. I can't,
I see these all the time. This is the best one. By far.
This is opening the door to a new future of spaceflight for the human race.
This spectacular shot of Musk's own cherry red Tesla with a dummy named Starman, don't panic, on the dashboard, headed for a solar orbit, and David Bowie playing in a forever loop.
Oh, my God.
That guy's cool. Okay, so while the launch was successful, it wasn't perfect, right? So the CEO of SpaceX, Elon Musk, says the rocket center booster, it missed the floating platform it was supposed to land on, and it unfortunately splashed into the Atlantic. But two out of three ain't bad.
Two out of three came back to land, and those first two are the ones that jettison early, so they are much closer to Cape Canaveral, easier to come back. That last one, the center rocket, goes so far out into space. By the time it releases, that's why he has a drone ship, a drone floating ship platform in the ocean that is trying to, like, maneuver and find it. So it's a little tough, but it was absolutely amazing. I was on my balcony watching, trying to see it. We saw a little smoke trail way off in the distance, but I found myself like that girl you saw in the package yelling. I've been to a couple down there. It starts going, and I just all of a sudden turn, go, dude, go, dude. Mm-hmm. And I'm like screaming at the TV. And then as it got up, I just look over it, and my roommate is watching it, and I go, he did it. He did it. Like, he launched the most powerful rocket off this planet ever in history. And like, this is going to be one of those moments that 30 years from now, 50 years from now, we're going to look back and be like, this change in the technology and rethinking this whole process is going to change the way we
How
do stuff.
How many people were thinking about the Tesla, too?
Tesla.
Because that's a cool part of it, was that space-suited mannequin, by the way, who was sitting in the driver's seat, one hand on the steering wheel,
good.
The other one on the side. It's a convertible, obviously.
Endless roadster.
So he decided to put that in there to have a little bit of fun. See that? Don't panic in the middle.
So how great is that?
So that is, I guess, a reference to Journey to the, what was this, the book series. It used to be,
Journey to the Center of the Sun?
No, it started out as either a radio show, and then it turned out to a series. It's a comic science fiction book.
Oh, okay.
And so, Hitchhiker's Guide to the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. That's it. All right, get it out.
And he named it Starman.
Yeah, and they were playing the David Bowie song.
David Bowie, Ground Control to Major Tom. And that was blasting afterwards. It was just so, so cool. And like normally on those launches, when they're doing a test launch and a payload, you know, they just put a brick in there. They put a weight. But no, not Elon Musk. He does everything different. Because that's boring to put just a weight in there.
I think next time they do the launch, you absolutely must go.
Oh.
I know
some people don't get it and aren't into it, but it's like it's one of those things you won't get until 30 years from now, and you see the technology and the base on the moon, and then we're launching from the moon to Mars, and then there's a base on Mars, and like,
and David Bowie's going along for the ride.
What a time to be alive. Updates though, stay tuned to SpaceX, because there's going to be updates. It has to pass through an asteroid belt coming up in a month or two, so that could get a little sketchy.
Okay, well, I know you'll stay on top of it, so yeah. No need for us to stay on top of it, because we know we'll get the update from you, which is exciting stuff. Yeah. Speaking of exciting stuff, the Winter Olympics are right around the corner. Mm-hmm. Opening ceremonies are this Friday. The competition gets underway on Thursday, so now some of the athletes are making their final preparations, and that includes figure skating, the pairs competition. So this was just, I think, this morning. China and Germany expected to rival for the top spot. There's a husband and wife team, the only U.S. couple at the field. And then there's also American siblings who are going to be competing as well. And they're hoping to place high on the podium.
That's pretty cool. Yeah, they're all practicing. I want to throw up for them. I'm nervous for them. I mean, are you kidding me? Like, this is your biggest moment. You've trained for 4 years, and here it comes. Thursday, they start their competition.
I know, and it's like they have to wait another 4 years, but you think positively. I'm sure, I know that they have trained, because you've seen the stories, you've read their backgrounds and bios, and they've trained a lot of them their whole lives for this.
Yeah, and they, the figure skaters are already on site. There's a send-off for other Olympians getting ready to take off on their journey to South Korea. Athletes have been traveling out of San Francisco International Airport to Seoul since late January. 16 members of the U.S. freestyle ski team flew out late yesterday. Athletes were thankful for the support before taking off for the Winter Olympic Games as crowds gathered around them, cheering and waving American flags. They're going to touch down at Seoul 4:30 p.m. today after their 12-and-a-half-hour flight. I did that flight.
It's a long flight.
A lot of movies.
You got to get up and walk around. Yeah. And here locally, there are a lot of people who are going to be celebrating the Winter Olympics over at the Jacksonville Ice and Sportsplex.
That's right. And you can win a family four-pack to the festivities this Friday. Festivities kick off at 7 p.m. with the Jacksonville Children's Chorus, special skating performances by U.S. Figure Skating Championship gold medalist Zoe Larson and Nick Hubert, silver medalist Joanna and William Hubert, and seven-time national competitor Alexander Aiken. Log on to First Coast News Facebook page and click the sweepstakes link. Register and you could join us for the 2018 Winter Games celebration. It's sponsored by the Jacksonville Ice and Sportsplex and WTLV NBC 12. It's going to be really cool. Watch the opening ceremonies Friday. And in some really cool stuff I'm doing back at the zoo, I've got a new series that I'll be doing every week at the zoo. And this one, we're starting out with the bears. I'm going to teach you something. Check it out. Hey folks, this week's Wildin' Out at the Zoo is here with Betsy the Bear and Lindy the Human. And what we're doing today is we're talking about how the zoo trains and treats these animals voluntarily. How do you guys do that, Lindy?
So we do all of our training through operant conditioning. So I use a clicker, and whenever I click, she knows that she did what I wanted her to do, so she gets a reward for it. Easiest way to start teaching them that is just you hand them a piece of food.
Look at that.
And you click, and they eventually learn, like, click means I get a snack. I don't go in with her because she's very dangerous.
Yes,
so
those
the
are
easiest,
very long claws.
Yes, the easiest way to check different parts of her body, you want to give me your tongue? Is just to train her to present different parts of her body. So this way I can see how her tongue is doing. You ready? You want to open?
Oh,
I can
wow.
look inside of her mouth and see that like her teeth are nice and clean. I'll come lay down.
That's amazing. Yeah, it's not just about cool tricks. This is actually about helping the
yes.
bear and helping the animals.
Foot. You can check under their feet. And this way, some other stuff that we train them to do, she knows how to get shots. She'll
voluntarily take a needle?
She'll voluntarily take a needle.
I won't even do that.
Yeah, so
I
that
have to be
way,
held down.
She doesn't have to go to the vet unless it's
can
like
I
a real emergency. Yes,
there
go
you go,
ahead.
Little girl. Oh, my God. I'm sorry. That is
good
so cool.
Job, lady.
I just fed a bear. That's so cool. Thanks so much, Lindy. Thanks so much, Betsy. Great job. There you go. Wilding out at the zoo. Another reason to come check out our zoo. It's the greatest in the world, according to me. But you can check them out at jacksonvillezoo.org. But the best way to find out about the zoo is to get on up here and come see these amazing animals. All right, Betsy. Thanks. I like the ombre look you got going there. It's pretty sweet.
She says, yeah, I get it every summer.
Cool. So cool. Yeah, they use that kind of a voluntary treatment for the animals so they can come and go as they please when they're doing checkups and stuff. It's crazy. So it's really neat. Check out the zoo. Get up there. JacksonvilleZoo.org for more information. All right, after the break, I'm going to